Today is November 11th, 1998. We are with Rosa Feiler, name at birth, Jacobovitz.
Yeah.
The interviewer is Ruth Meyer. We are in Elmwood Park, New Jersey, in the United States. And this interview will be conducted in English. Hi, I'm Ruth Meyer, M-E-Y-E-R. Today is November 11th, 1998.
Yeah.
We are in Elmwood Park, New Jersey, in the United States, with Rosa
Feiler.
And maiden name at birth is Jacobovitz.
That's
and right. This interview will be conducted in English.
Yeah.
Let's begin by having you state your name at birth. What was your maiden name, first name and last name?
Jacobovitz.
And your first name when you were born?
Jacobovitz, too.
Yes.
Born Jacobovitz.
And what was your first name? Were you Rosa Jacobovitz?
Jacobovitz, yes.
Uh-huh. What did your parents call you?
Rizal.
Rizal?
Yeah.
I see.
Because we were Orthodox, very not on the names, you know. Not Polish name. Here I had a rose, a Polish Ruja. Polish, you know.
Mm-hmm. And your name now?
Now is my name Rosa Feiler. F-E-I-L-E-R.
Okay. And you had told me earlier that you had been married once before. And what was your name then?
Then my name was Kinross. Rosa Kinross.
Can you
husband. And boy's husband.
Right. Can you spell Kinross for me?
Yeah. K-E-N-R-U-S. Kinross.
Okay. And what town were you born in?
I'm born in Novoradomsko. Radomsko.
And where is that?
That is near Pietike. Pietiko.
And what country?
Radomsko.
And the country?
The country was Pietiko.
Was that Poland, Russia?
Poland, not
in Poland.
Everything Poland, yeah, Poland.
Okay.
I'm Polish.
Okay, the survivor does not want to discuss age or date of birth. I'd like to know a little bit about your family when you were a young person. What was your father's name?
My father's name was Wolf Jacobovitz. My mother's name was Sura Jacobovitz. My mother's name was Volkovich in the house, you know. And my mother not married. Her name was Volkovich.
Uh-huh.
You know, when she not was married, her name was Volkovich from her parents. Now, my husband, my father was Jacobovitch. He married me then.
Right.
So she got license Jacobovitch and the children Jacobovitch.
And where was your father born?
My father was born in Przebysz. Przebysz.
Is that also in Poland?
No, that's just a little part of Novoradomsko. Not so far. No, it's a country, not a big one. Mm-hmm. A smaller like Radomsko, you know.
It was a smaller
town. A smaller town, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And what did your father do for a living? How did he...
My husband was...
Your father.
Yeah, my father was a carpenter, but he transferred to Paris, to London, Express, because he sent magazines. And we make furniture. When somebody married, furniture, beds, closets. Everything is making, you know, no good, you know, not like of like here. No, everything is no good. We all five people working with the machine, by the machine, by the wash pads, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody got a machine to work. Everything is there. Yeah.
What do you remember of your father? What kind of a man was he? Do you remember him?
Yeah, I remember. He was very tall. I was the smallest in the house. Every children was very tall. Even the class, I sit the first one because I'm not that big. You know, honest, in the class, I was the smallest too. Later, I grow up, you know, not late. I don't want to see when over the administration I started to grow, you know? Yeah.
Well, tell me.
And my mother said, when I know you, so not nice girl, I don't have you.
Well, what was your feeling about your father? Did you like to spend time with him?
I make every year chat, you know, every year. And I
okay,
get,
but what about when you were a little girl? Did you go places with your father?
He go and he bring me cherry. He hang me up off my ear. And he play with me anytime. He take me off the floor that I remember. Maybe I was the youngster, you know. Everybody was jealous in the house. Other parents love me, not know me. And my father, anytime he bring me a doll, I remember, you know, cause a lot of money, you know. And he say, for you everything, I love you, my father. So. And he buy a earring, not earring, no cherry earring, a very good lot of money. He bring me and he give me the enter bag and he say, give everybody, not just for you, my father. So I was all 6 years when my father passed away.
What? How did he die?
Well, my father died and he got pneumonia. And you know, in Europe, you know. And to that he got stroke, and he passed away. He not got a leg sick. In the house, we don't got a trouble, not off the floor. It's coming my neighbors. He take me from the school, and my father lay down with a black coat off the floor. But he go a Yibitzer, you know, like the Orthodox Jew, you know. But he go in the place, so black, you know. A black hole because he was told that what he wear is was covered off the floor. And I came from the school, I fall up of my father. That I remember, and I yell it so. I don't, everybody take me up, I don't want to go up. I say I want to go with my daddy. That I remember. I fall up and I came, I say he not in the bed. Because before we take him home, in the house, in the hospital. Mm-hmm. And I come from school, I see he's off the floor, covered, not I don't see it. I want to take him up, he don't let me. Mm-hmm. They call to you know what he covered.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now my mother was so good, she don't want to marry. She say, I'm the rich woman, daddy left me 6 houses. Big communities, you know, because every child is nice, not crippled, and that I'm rich. Nobody's so rich with me. And good children, she. I got a brother, he don't go down May because he was the father for now. The government don't take him, you know. Is sending a letter because he is the father of...
Is this your oldest brother?
Yeah, the oldest, Leib.
Leib was his name?
Yeah, Leib is my oldest brother. So he was the father, and he giving ski scarf. You know what ski scarf? The hand
When you get married?
Of the cemetery. Oh. When he grabbed, he gave father the hand, you know. He is the father for now. You know, the family, my mother, forced him to do that, you know. My mother, she don't give him a hand, you know. He have my brother, but he's 20 years old, and he was the father for now. And when he want to go and move it, he say to Ma, so you can give me a lot of dollars. He don't take child, no, he has Ma, and every child, so.
So Leib was the oldest, who
the oldest, the father for
he
now.
He was the father then,
yeah,
after
the
your father.
I say he was my father too, he was very
right.
Good to everybody. When he married, he was only 8 years married, because he don't want to go out. You believe me? 3 children married before he, and he don't want to marry. He say I have to take care of me and of my mother.
Then who was next after Live? Have something to drink. It's right there.
No. I tell you, when I talk about it, because I remember that, you know.
Who was after Live? Who's next in the family?
Apple, my sister.
Your sister. Yeah. And what did she do?
My sister was a dressmaker.
In Radomska?
Yeah.
Okay. And who was after her? Who was
Yankel.
Yankel?
Yeah.
And what did he do?
A carpenter.
Was he a Yankel?
I think one got a beauty shop. Yankel, I think.
Yankel was a barber?
A barber.
For men and women or just for men?
Just for men.
Okay.
Just for men.
And who was next after Yankel?
Avrum.
And what did he do?
He carpeted.
So did he work in the business that your father
Yeah, he moved from Berlin. My brother is living in Berlin, you know.
In Germany?
In Germany, yeah. He married and he lived there.
I see.
Yeah. No, Hitler made kaput him either. He finished it.
Yeah. And then who was next after Avrum?
Moshe, Moses.
And what did Moshe do?
Moshe was a boy, but he do everything. He was everything do handy, and no child was born like he was. And he was beautiful, nice, the whole children nice.
And then, but what did he do for a living? Did he also work in the family business?
He working not so much, no, he was more electricity, different kinds of things. He don't work much carpet.
I see.
He was special handy to everything. He so was also, I don't can tell you, but he bought the most electrician things.
So you said that you were the youngest, so were
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I'm the baby. In the
after Moshe came
yeah,
you.
Yeah, every 2 years I try.
Every 2 years?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, every 2 years coming a boy.
Okay. Tell me a little bit about life in Radomsko when you were a youngster.
Yeah.
Can you tell me what kind of a house you lived in?
My brother.
You. What kind of house?
Well, we
did
got
you live
a
in?
Big house, you know, because we were like not so big house. Two bedrooms and a kitchen. We were 8 people with the mother, 8 people, you know. No, but you know, I don't can say I come from very rich because, you know, we got to eat. My mother, rest in peace, she was so good. It's come a bedroom and we were the whole children, the house, not married. It's come a bedroom, winter time, old, blonde, you know, one character under. In wintertime cooking soup. My mother say, he knocking in the door, my mother say, come on. So what my mother do, she put it in a cup for the 2 cup for the soup. And my brother say, it's not fair, ma. And look it, you take away from us the food. Mama say, children, don't say that. You have to be happy. Because you can go 100 houses, nobody give a little warm because it's so cold. The bed is with ice, he don't see the wall. We have to help people, children. Don't live like you live alone. No, we have to help people. Rich people don't giving. No, because we poor are giving. Because I feel if we don't have enough, so we have to help either. Then I have.
So did you have a guest or an oirech often in the house?
What?
Did your mother bring people very often?
Not so often. When brothers go sometimes to Davina, when he say, a poor Jew, yid, you know, Jew. He say in the shul Friday, he come from another country. To my brother say, come with me home, my 2 brothers. He coming home because we got from the beginning we got a ladder, you know, and later on, when my father passed away, and later we got a lot of big business, and we got from everything in sex. We got everything, flour, arbets, you know arbets.
Arbets?
Yeah, arbets, everything in sex, you know, because we buy a lot of the pound because we were a big family.
So you bought it in big containers, in big quantities.
Yeah, and my mother's giving. She is going to school and she give for the poor children. She put them in the bed, flowers, and she cook for the children. My mother's doing. She was so good. I tell you, when somebody was sick in our court, we live in the communities, you know. So my mother put in soup. She take a fliegele for her baby, you know. She was somebody about sick and she make a haircut. That's for that. And she go in the house and she drink because she don't have it. That is doing in my home, you know. A bit of lotion, noodle, you know. And she make a 3 cup. That if a dead children, she say, we don't have a lunch. Thank God. We have it, so we have to give.
Can you tell me about Shabbos in your house when you were a little girl?
Yeah. Shabbos is coming before. We rip the paper in the bathroom, not the rice, the paper, newspaper. We don't got paper like here.
Did you have a bathroom inside or outside the
outside.
House?
Outside.
Mm-hmm.
Outside we go, and it's outside. You know, go in wintertime, excuse me, about so high, excuse me, crack one, because it's freezing, you know. In mama candle, the candle, have the shoes, everything have to be clean, you know, before Shabbos, not Shabbos. Oh, it's coming, I go, you know, a janitor, but she's coming. Saturday, she make the guest door.
Mm-hmm.
She make me boring. And 12 o'clock, she's coming because it's coming the children in the bakery, you know. Mama kindled the candle. And, you know, in by Shabbos is Shabbos. The brother's going to shul. He coming home. He washed to the challah. You know? He washed to the challah.
Did you help your mother with preparations? Did you help with preparations?
Yeah, I help.
Did she teach you how to bake a challah?
Yeah, I bake. I show you in the kitchen. I bake, I got a mixer, I make sponge cake and honey cake and apple pie, 3 pieces apple pie. I bake here, you can ask everybody, I have 2 boys, I got an army. And I give now too, you believe me. You go to my refrigerator, you don't believe it, I got cake, I got bread, and I giving away because money he don't want it, you know. He say money is no good. No, when you give something, we appreciate it. We don't want money. We don't need clothes. We don't need. No, when you do.
But let's go back a little bit now, though, to Poland, to your parents' house.
Yeah.
So you said that they went. Your father and your brothers went to the shul on Friday night.
Yeah, he bring him a neuer.
He brought home a guest.
Yeah, a guest that's a Jewish a neuer.
Right.
You know, a guest Friday, mm-hmm. And the Shabbos even too bring him fish to give. You know, challah, cake, a pizza cut up and to give, and he eat together what we eating by the table. But we eat shul every not just for us, not for that people too. But we eat, he eating too, you know, mm-hmm. 2 people.
And tell me, where did you go to school?
Who?
You.
I go in public school, and later from the public school, I go in the Baisianke.
You what
know
did
what
you
a
learn?
Baisianke is?
Tell me what
is a Baisianke?
You tell me what about the Baisiakov school.
And the Baisiakov is learning to, you know, is learning to make, to daven, to make moidiani, you know, in the morning, to moidiani, lafneku, melakave, kaev, you know, Jewish pray to God, you know. That's what I tell you in Hebrew talk. And we learn everything. We learn not to make sins, you know, to correct, be good to parents. And when you go off the street, when you see somebody don't can walk and vice versa. So you have to help people to go when not to kill. When a car is coming, and to help people. And he learned everything, orthodox things, you know. What we have to play when you go governor, and how you have, when you go sleep, my like name is Maya, so will you know, everything, you know. And by saying, in the house, mom did the same thing. No, mom said to me, I don't have patience to ask. It's costing money, you know, and by saying, I'm not for nothing. Mm-hmm. And I learned they are governor. And I learned everything that, you know, we have to live.
And in Base Yaakov,
yeah.
Was it only for girls?
Yeah, just like it. The boys got the besmadrish, and the rabbi special.
How long did you go to Base Yaakov? How many
in
years?
In Base Yaakov, I go 4 years. And I learned.
What about in the public school?
In the public school, well, in the public school, we learn writing, arithmetic.
Did you learn in Polish?
Yeah.
Did you learn any other language
yeah.
in the public school? What language?
In the public school, we learn Polish. That's all.
That's all.
And I learned, I speak Deutsch. I speak good Polish. I speak Russian. And I speak Yiddish, and I speak a little Hebrew, not much.
Where did you learn your German and your Russian?
In Germany, where I live.
Where did you learn German? In Germany?
No, before. Before.
Did you learn it in school?
No, we got a neighbor, but she learned me, a neighbor in Poland. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my friend, we were neighbors, and the mother learned me.
In the public school that you went to, were there Jewish children and non-Jewish children?
In the school, in public, not Jewish, yeah. Now, later is making, but later, now, 3 years before, making just Jewish children, because the state is coming. Fathers, you know what a father is from the church.
Uh-huh.
He don't want
priest?
It to father Jewish people. Blessing, you know, he don't want it. He's making mix up our Polish, so he making separate Polish, separate. Now, together, woman, girls and boys in the public school. Yeah, together. And
you went
up.
Together.
And before, because the father don't want to bless the Jewish children. You understand what I say? Blessing, you
so
know.
What when the priest came, when the father came, where did the Jewish children go?
No, so we separated, you know, we separated. He don't want to come together. You know how it's looking in Poland.
Well, when you were a young person, when you were a child in school, did you feel any anti-Semitism?
Well, sometimes he fold up and he flash you for nothing. The Polish.
And Polish
when
teacher?
Over the wall, the Polish people, we come back to Poland, he said, oh, you still living? Hitler asked him, killed everybody, and I say, you lied at you, because you killed Jesus. So God punished us. You punished the Hitler killers. The Polish people said that.
After the war?
Yeah, after. Nach dem Krieg.
Right,
Nach
after.
Krieg, after. When we came home, we came visiting, saying to my home, say, we have a home or something, so he say, is good for us because you killed Jesus.
Okay, tell me a little bit about the synagogue that you went to. Do you know the name of it or the rabbi's name?
I don't know the name of it.
Do you remember where the synagogue was?
Yes, I go in Lodz, you mean. In Lodz.
No, in Radomska.
Yeah, in Radomska. It's by, it's about one big shul and about small shuls, you know.
And which one did you and your family go to?
And the
know?
Big one, the big shul.
And where was that? Do you
that's
know?
Of what states, I don't remember. Mm-hmm. I go.
Did you go? Did you like to
I
go?
I go mikvah too. You know what mikvah
did you go
is?
When did you start going to the mikvah?
That's about of the grod of gas in the mikvah. You know what the mikvah.
Can you tell me about it?
Yes, well, the mikvah is here is different in the United States, you know, here.
Tell
different.
Me how it was in Poland.
In Poland, but the mikvah, you know, I got very long hair, two ponytails, big one, so thick, one side. Now, but my husband don't like it, I cut the hair. And I like it too, I got big ponytail too. I make a lot of round, a lot of hair, a course like that, you know. No, but when you go in the mikvah, the water, you know, you go into the water, you know. And when you stay in the water and when you picking up and down, then you have to make the prayer from the candle. Because that's before marriage, you know. So you go in the mikvah the first time, you know, I tell you that. So that's before you married, you have to have. And I think you were, and if you don't can get married, and you were married, even with my husband, the same in Germany too. We got a mikvah. So I go to the mikvah, and he learned me to say the prayer from the candle. And but my hair so long, I make 3 times more because of the hair showing. He say more than. I say I don't care more because the hair, you know, is coming up and die. So he give me a punishment again 3 times more. You understand? In the water, but there is no good, I tell you, because the water like smelling here going automatic. When you going in the mikvah here, the water going down right away. It's nothing water. And when you going in, it's coming the water, you got it. You're not from every poison. You understand?
Right.
In Europe is saying everybody make 50 of the bath. You're not no good. I say I never go, but I have to go my parents, you know. When I come to Lord, I go. In the Radomska, I say a lie, I go to my mother because I move to Lord. Mm-hmm. You know?
Okay, well, we'll get to
my
this.
Sister.
Tell me what you did when you were finished with school. You said you went to public school in Bais Yaakov.
Yeah.
Did you go to school after that?
Are you going to school?
After that time?
No.
Did you go to any more school? Did you get any special training?
Yeah, I had training, Schneiden.
As a seamstress?
Yeah,
where did you
I
learn that?
In my special school.
What kind of school?
In Lodz.
In Lodz? You went to Lodz?
Yeah.
How old were you when you went to Lodz?
Well, when I married, I go to Lodz.
I see. And then you went to school after you were married?
Yeah.
I see. Okay, we'll stop here and change tape. Rosa Feiler, take 2. Now, you said that you went to Ludge when you got married. Did you get married in Ludge or in Radomska?
In Radomska, my brother make a big wedding.
Tell me about
my life. Make a big wedding in the house of a rabbi, but she don't care. She married a rabbi's daughter, and she don't can have babies. So the rabbi say, who is a using but don't have parents? So I give out. My mother is going for that dressing. She got everything with the rhinestones, you know, rabbi's daughter, you know, rabbi shuttle's daughter's dress, with the crown, with everything, with the balloon, you know. And
for
my
you?
Mother for me of the wedding. And she don't give me over the wedding, my mother give back, you know. But for everybody that don't have a father, a mother, so she giving for you, so me, you know. I use him, but don't have Elton. So she give my mother, and you believe me, my mother-in-law and his family is coming of the wedding. He's saying that is a prince. Honest to God, I wear dress, you know. My mother don't buy it for me, no, I tell you. She bought it, you know.
Right.
And I put it in by my brother's house. He got very, very big home, my brother. He house, you know. He got him a cow, too. A cow.
Really?
Yeah, he got a big house built up. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful one family house, my brother. And he making a wedding. He buying a calf, you know what a calf?
A calf.
A kelbo, a small kelbo.
A small cow, a baby cow.
And a turkey, and geese. It's why, you know, over 60 people at my wedding, you know.
Tell me about your husband. What was his name?
My name's husband is Solomon Kinross.
And how had you met him? How did you meet him?
I meet him at Vanna Theater. You know, and I sit with a friend, you know, with my Gilbert, my girlfriend. And well, we sit and he sit by my hand and we started to talk. And he say, maybe I can help you live. I say, well, I don't care, can give you because I don't know you, you don't know me, I'm sorry. He say, I'm very interested. Don't worry, he say, I'm not, but I kill you or something. He talked to me, so, well, I say, I live off the Schoenig house, off the Schoenig 18. But, he say, I'd like to see you. I say, well, okay, I say, when you can. He say, I come Saturday night. He is coming, we gone out, now we were more than a year we gone together, we not married. No, he was such a good to me, you know. Late, I from the beginning, you know, what I dress, what I got money, what I work, I send to my mother. She have to pay rent and everything, and I grow, my cold for this year. Grow up, the cold fabric here, not nice dress. But I tell him the truth, when we go now, I don't have a father, I have a mother. I but my sister.
Were you living at your sister's?
Who?
Were you living at Ethel's house?
Yes.
In Ludge, right?
In Ludge, after Scotland Action.
And did you work for her too? Did
I
you work with her?
Yeah, I work. I got work. I got a machine, and I take out cut machine. You know, got this. You know what got this? Hemde, over hemde, nice over hemde, dressing over hemde. I make everything. You know, pajamas, everything is cut out, and I sew it. You know, I take that in the big stores. But he handled me that, you know. And I bought that. And the money, I don't make much either. I was lazy too much too. I got the children, my sister, she got two children. And I work how much I can, you know. And that's what I work. I buy for my mother a lot of things, nice shoes, she go to the shoes. I send the money. You know, it's my mother. I say, one time I rob at the register and I steal it and I send home my pocket. And I don't say my husband, and my husband won't divorce with me because then you tell me you want for your mother that you don't have to steal it. Because he's safe in the post office, the car, I send a bigger package, you know, material for dresses. But he know I was honest to my mother, you know. He apologize. I apologize to him. I don't do more. When you want, you tell me what I give you anytime. What you want. You believe me, I remember that. Yeah. I steal it from the register, you know. And I look at where I was good.
From your from where your husband?
Huh?
From your husband's business you took it?
That was together with my father.
Mm-hmm. What did he do?
My husband is doing, he learned a piano play. And he teach about piano.
Okay, so you were...
No, he ran the bakery, too. He worked in the bakery. He do Shabbos to have money, you know. He put in children, you know, children, what is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he worked together.
I see. And when did you get married? What year was it? Do you know?
I think 36.
In 1936?
Yeah, 36.
And did you have any children?
Yeah, a daughter, a little baby.
And what was her name?
Chaya Sura, the guy.
Chaya Sura?
Chaya Sura.
Who was she
two names she got.
Right, who was she named after?
She got a name from my husband's father's sister. She passed away, so he gave. And Sura for my family, you know.
But wasn't your mother's name Sura?
My mother's name is Sura, so I don't call her Sura no Chayla.
I see.
Because I don't want to call, because he giving up. And my husband's family giving us that name too. Mm-hmm. So I say it's two names, or I call her Chayla. Nish Chayla Sura. You understand?
Yes, I understand.
Sure, is given a machine game higher because I demonstrate of this. I don't like it. I say I got a living mother.
Right.
You know, so he don't can change it over. So I call it higher. You understand?
I understand.
My husband too higher.
I understand.
Now you know, she got two names, higher too.
Sure. And then you were living in Lodge
at
the time?
Yeah, the whole, yeah.
Uh-huh. What happened when Hitler came?
When Hitler came, he sent bombs in Lodz, in Radomsko, to the radio give over every hour. The radio's giving what he do. It's coming a lot of jeeps in Lodz. Jeeps in airplanes, in the hundreds of airplanes, and he bombed. He put a bump, he don't, bump, 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 bump. And everybody, you know we going off Kiddush Hashem, you know. And that's the end, Kiddush Hashem.
Did you think you were going to die then?
Yeah, we thinking that we dying anyway. And the Germany people that is living in Lodz too, he's saying, he's showing too, he making very back the general, you know, the German. At about 9.
Were you living in a neighborhood where there were Germans living too? There were Gentiles?
A three couple they are living. German.
Were you friends with them?
No. No, at about he giving over a lot of things, you know. Like the Polish people, when he say, a Jew, he said that, a Jude, the Poland, you know, in Lodz the same thing, that is Jude, here. I will stay up in the morning for a piece of bread in the line, you know. She giving a piece of bread. The Germans stay now there in his shack in the line too. And the people told him that like apple going down, you know. His shack, he take guns like he got the machine gun there. Throw guns in his shack, pull.
Was this right
the
at German,
the beginning? The SS.
Was this right at the beginning?
That's from the beginning, he shopping
really?
Right away.
Right. Yeah. Right. So the Germans came into Lodz in September of 1939.
Yeah.
What happened then? How long were you able to stay in your house?
Well, to stay in the house, I think 1941, 42, it was published after war's all over. Everybody has to go to work. When somebody don't work, it's killing, you know?
Okay, now, was that before they started the Lodz ghetto, before they made the ghetto? Or
yeah, before he made the ghetto.
Before
everybody
they made the ghetto.
Had to go to work.
Okay.
Well, it's making resorts. Schneider Resort, Kirchner Resort, Shoe Resort, Finstrow, you know, Shoe, not leather. Different, I mean, everything was a short. I worked in Blaugrund.
Before the ghetto?
Yes.
Before the
ghetto, we have to go work.
So were you able to live in your own house then?
Later on, he made the ghetto.
Okay. Now, when you went to work like that, who watched your baby? Who took care of the baby?
The baby? I got a neighbor. She got two... A mother, an old mother, and she take care
of
her neighbor. And she got her grandchildren too, and my grandchildren, because her daughter's going to work too. Old people not, you know, old people don't get, and she take care of them.
And what about your husband? What was he doing?
My husband is working the bakery down, in a bakery, by the father.
Even after everybody was he able to keep that business private?
Yeah.
Even after Hitler came?
Yeah, he worked in the start to work by the father, you know, when
he
Germany was, when Germany came in.
He still was able?
Yeah, with the father and the business. And
did you have to wear a star to identify yourself?
Yeah, a star we have to go. And we have to go to work. We're going to work at Blaugrund Resort, Kirchner Resort. After Smogovic 6, I worked there. I worked there how long this is making clean Lichtmannstadt. It's making clean, you know, clean out the Jew in Lichtmannstadt. No Jew more in Lichtmannstadt.
And Lichtmannstadt was the name given to Lodz.
Yeah, that's a Lodz. Lodz. Everybody had to go. It's making appeals.
Okay. Was this before the ghetto or then after the ghetto? When did you go into the ghetto?
I think 1942. 41.
You went into the ghetto?
Or the 41. Maybe I mixed up or the 42 or the 41.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tell me about when you had to go into the ghetto.
Yeah, we won the ghetto. It was very bad.
Where did you live in the ghetto?
After Dolna Twelle, I lived. And that was after Lagovnitska gas. It was there, the ghetto, you know, close. I do have something, this is the Brezina gas, you can walk. You know, this is the Brezina gas. And so it's where we have to go, not go down, but we wouldn't do it. And we stay in the lines. We got bathroom costume making in those stores to go for every week for you, what ungeteilt was that to be given, you know, to eat. To give a two potato, he give a little. I get arbis, a little dirt, also doing the tittle, he give you a piece of bread, he give you a difference how many people you are. Not he give you 3 pieces of bread, you know.
How old was your baby at this time when you went into the ghetto?
The old he was? When I go in
Into the ghetto.
Into the ghetto. Is she bound or not? A couple weeks.
She was an infant when you went into the ghetto?
Huh?
She was an infant? She was a tiny baby when you went into the ghetto?
No, she was old, more than a year.
A year?
Yeah, more than 2 years she was old.
She was 2 years old?
Yeah, 2 years, baby.
What happened?
What happened? What happened? You know, happened that he cut at the children on the floor and in there. And because he shot me for that, he take away the baby.
And who is he? Tell
the
me.
The SS.
The SS. Why?
Yeah, when we go to meet our bill, and you don't can have children.
So you took your baby to the Appell with you in Lodge
no,
in the ghetto?
No, we don't can get it because he's taking away.
When?
In the ghetto, we got the baby. In the ghetto, he take away the baby. We were in the ghetto. He's making, the day we have to give away the babies. And I don't give away, you know. I got my daughter in the house. Now, but when we go to Appell, so we have to give the key closed, so I have to take out my baby. So when I go down, I got the baby, so he shot, take it 2 times, and I want to go to the baby, go picking up, so he shot me in my leg.
The SS man shot you in the leg?
Yes.
In the ghetto, in the Lodge
In
camp.
The ghetto. And
did
that
he shoot is, you?
I was in Germany, in Lager, you know, and that everything is a little high up here because, you know, I don't get the report now. I hold me something. Now, sometimes it's stinking a little, you know, the eye, because inside is falling, you know. But sometimes I don't get walk him. So he picked me up and we're going to work. We machine it, the Arbeit, you know. At me machen to go in with the shoulder, I'm so machen schiet, mach so nicht stein bleiben. You know, because I don't can walk.
Your the, friends helped you? Your friends carried?
Hey, by the shoulder. Hold
right,
me.
Your friends.
We walk. So I say, I don't can more. I have to get up there. I say, I don't say nothing. No, you walk, we can help you. So he picked me so by the shoulder.
Sure.
And down, and he put in the hand, and he picked me. So, and when it's coming, when we get free, so I got everything the bone before.
Well, we'll get to that. We're getting ahead too much. Now, at the time, your baby was shot.
Yes.
Sorrel,
yeah, he
shot
don't
her
shot,
with
no,
a gun?
He killed her. He bent her.
He hit, threw her on the
floor? Yeah, off the floor. And I want to go. I think I should leave. So but I go, bent, she shot.
Where was your husband?
Huh?
Where was your husband?
My
when
husband
this happened?
Was in poison and lager. He taken before.
He was already in the camp, in concentration camp.
No, yeah, he was the food from what he taken.
What happened?
Because he taken out, you know, the young people have to go to work.
Do you remember when that was?
My husband say I have to go because I don't wanna go and be going. I have to work, and he going in poison lager. The lager was poison lager.
Was poison?
And poison. It's not poison to eat. No, the lager is poison.
Poison,
yeah.
Oh,
and he killed him. Because the road cross is looking, I think he's living over the wall, or they're looking. The road cross find me too, because he take me in the hospital.
Right. Okay, but that's after the war. Do you remember when it was that your husband was taken? What year or what time of the year?
What?
When your husband was taken to the camp to pose?
My husband is taken to camp in 1941.
Do you remember that day?
No.
But do you remember, were you together that day? When he left, were you able to say goodbye?
He say goodbye because I know, but they just know, I don't
right.
think.
Did you think when your husband left to go to the camp, did you have any idea what was going to happen?
I cry, we both crying, you know, well, it's not so happened, it's to say, we both crying, he say, God thinks we see again, and we crying, and you know, like babies, you know, the love, I like him, he was very, he was good, rich, too. I was rich when I married him.
So, where were you living in the Lodz ghetto?
In the Lodz ghetto?
Yeah.
I live up the Pjezinagas.
Pjezinagas?
Yeah.
How many people lived in the house you were living in? What were the living conditions?
I lived me with my husband.
Anybody else in the apartment with you?
No. Later on, when we go in the ghetto, it's not alone, number three people.
Right.
Not,
tell me
not,
about that.
Not that, like you say, when we in the ghetto.
Right. Tell
taking
me.
Other covered people from different ghetto people from other countries, he bringing clothes. So we have to take in people, you know, everybody.
So in the ghetto, did you have to share an apartment?
Well, I got a girl, but she not married, two but we don't got big, one room. In the ghetto.
Right.
In the ghetto of the Donuts Valley, I got the ghetto. So we live, I and a girl, but she's also about 22, 24 years. You know, her name is Rapoport, I know, because a neighbor, you know. And I say, surely you come with me, we both together, that's all. And I got there in the ghetto, one room, you know, not two. Now one room, big, thin here, busy, that's in
did
the ghetto.
Did you have a kitchen?
The kitchen together, not a kitchen separate.
Yeah.
A little.
And was there running water? Did you have running
water?
Yeah, water,
I got it. Yeah.
And did you have heat in the winter?
No, we have to make it.
Were you able to get wood or coal?
I make from the gas stove, but from the oven, but I got it. I don't got a gas stove in my oven, but I am in the ghetto, but I make heat. In the oven,
and you had enough to make.
Well, enough. We bought him dressing. We got to put it in, you know. And we don't work so much either. We have to go on the money for a piece of bread.
Right. Did you have enough to eat in the ghetto?
Well, I got it. I don't can say it not because my father-in-law, my husband. He was before, when we were in the ghetto, he gone away, not before, in the ghetto. It's a vibe we have, you know, I was with my child in a meal, you know, I was today. No, we were scared because it's saying a German and Deutschen taking the meal. So we have to go to, I come back from the meal. But see, when you were behalten with the kids, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Na meal. Na mat gezoek at de Duits en gein ebenemme de meal. So my husband is coming and he take us home.
I see. Now, how did you get food for your baby?
We got it, a glass milk, you know, and we got it one eggs of a week. No, but we handle, you know, what I give dates, I give flour, I give a little pepper. I give toast bread, you know. She give me not a dose, give me a dose. You give me that, I give you that, you
right,
know.
Right.
You understand?
Was
money,
there, was there
money
meat?
Don't deserve. Everybody get that $100 to go. But you have to give the $100 when you go to the appel, and you give the key to the appel, and the key too. Are you close?
Mm-hmm. Were you able to get meat?
No, meat is making the oxidoxis mucky gum with. And nobody knows why such the Amazon is all skin. And
so were
the
you
sticker,
able?
You know, that's when we catch, I get means aloes. And muscat flies, kusha flies, the white oxidoxis.
You were able to get?
Yeah, a little, not
meat?
Much, or a little.
So what did
lot
you
of people
trade?
Eating. You know, Maki gave him fair flesh, you know, a piece of the butt, I don't know.
Fair is a horse.
A horse flesh, yeah. But not, you know, you, but we got cautious. Not much, a little cautious. When I came in that state, you want to give me 3 chicken, I say I want 1 chicken, no cautious. When I come to Texas. Mm-hmm. I don't want a 3, no 1, no kosher. Honest to God, I say honestly. I don't want 3, no 1.
Just 1 kosher 1?
Yeah, not kosher.
Okay.
So, I get it.
So in the ghetto, first your husband was taken, and then your baby. Did you stay in the ghetto? Were you still in the ghetto after your baby was killed?
Yeah, I stayed with the baby. I stayed with the baby, he taking care.
But after
in
the
lodge,
baby.
Lodge,
right, in the Lodge ghetto, you said your baby was killed, that the SS man took the baby and killed
no,
it.
No, I don't want to begin that. I don't want to begin.
And what happened then?
Then, that's what I tell you.
When did you leave the ghetto?
When I leave the ghetto, when it's making kosheriyat the bakeries. Kosheriyat, when the bakeries giving up, is the whole Lichmannstadt Lodge of the Gaven, the Rhein from the Juden.
They made it Juden Rhein. And
when
was
making
this?
The Juden Rhein.
Do you know when that happened?
Yeah. 1943.
Tell me what happened to you.
What happened? We go, and I'm kasheriyat by the bakeries, you know, because my husband and from the bakeries, husband there. I'm kasheriyat from Blaugrund, Fiete Resort, you know, Blaugrund.
You so worked at Blaugrund?
By Blaugrund.
What kind of work did you do there?
We worked of the machine, Fiete, Pelsen, you know,
fur?
For the soldiers. For the Germany. And we making what he shot in the Germany is lot of part what he shot at, so we have to cut out and to make under pelts, you know, not no one, not to cut out.
So you repaired?
What is my blood, you know?
Right.
So we cutting out his blood, don't think him out because it's a long, so we cutting out, he making under pelts, like a
so
lot of.
You patched and repaired the uniforms.
Yeah, and new one too. Mm-hmm. But the Germany is coming, but he wanted, we make it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But the Germany give the Jamaican new one too. It's a big shopper.
Right. Okay, so when were you?
I kissing you the salt, you know. Mm-hmm. That.
When were you taken out of the ghetto? When did you?
When everything is gone out, the shop going to everything have to
everything,
go.
Okay.
Everything.
Uh-huh.
Now we go when the Rumkowski is gone.
So at the very end?
Yeah, we go with the Rumkowski.
Tell me, before we get to that, tell me a little bit about Rumkowski. What did the people think of Rumkowski?
Well, I think so. He was a very good man when he was a bachelor. He never married. No, but he was a good man, the best man. He was in lodge because he take care of his women. He take care of widows, of children, of hiders, my kinder. He do a lot of things. No, when it's come to Germany in the ghetto, he make it other, but I think he do, and I don't can say because I not he kill him. He was the officer from Lichmannstadt, the father, the president.
Right.
In lodge.
Right.
Not so he married with a young girl, 22-year-old a girl. And he go not with a car, not with a droska. You know what a droska is? But with 2 Fayette, with 2 horses. Now beautiful he goes. And he giving abteilung in the stores what the Germany giving to eat.
Mm-hmm.
Kasche, Gruppen, Arbeit, you know, everything for a little. We come home, we don't have nothing, and we stay all day in the line, too. In the Reihe, you know, maybe stand in the Reihe.
Right.
It's a line, you know. But that became a day, Upteilung, to Essen.
The ration. Right. We'll stop
here. To Essen, you know.
Right. We'll stop here and change tape.
Rosa Feiler, tape 3. You were telling me about Rumkowski and how did people, what did people think of him? Did everybody think he was a good man?
Well, he's not that good because when he say a woman, she's pregnant. So he go, when she go in the wagon, then he come with kartoffel, potato.
Right.
And sie gelaufen, sie haben gewollt nehmen eine Kartoffel. Ich hat sie gelaufen und er hat angestanden, zu koppen mit der Fuß.
Rumkowski?
Rumkowski hat geschrien. Er hat sind Kurve, starten schlupfen mit den Männern jetzt und Kinder mit den Aussagen. Mit den Aussagen. We kill everybody. And but
did anybody use
it? I you know, jails. Hat mir gemacht bei Jakubowitschen. Ich gewählt die Jail. Und dort nicht gewesen, ich habe vergessen, wie er hat geheißen, wo es Aratugetier gerufen wird bei ihm gefunden. Ich habe vergessen, sein Name just now. Wo es er gewesen, Jakubowitsch. Er hat gehabt, Movies in zu essen, die ganze Logik gewählt bei ihm, was er hat umgegangen wird, der Jakubowitsch. Ich kam der Deutsch und hat das umgemastet. Ich hat ihn rausgenommen und hat ihn gegeben. Treppe, you know what Treppe ist? Schiehe, hosene Schiehe.
Und
ja, ich hat reingeklappt, Nägel. Und er hat das irgendwie gebrochen in dem. Und als er sie gewonnen hat, dann hat gerade eine Kummer, war hat so eine Sache umgetiert, der Jakubowitsch von der Twiese. Herzberg hat er geheißen.
Mhm.
Jetzt auch macht der Mann. Und er hat gesagt, Herzberg, und Jakubowitsch ist auch gewesen in der Mitte, you know, beide together. Wo es am Mund gegangen wird, und was sei gewesen. Man hat gefunden, so eine Sache, wo es sei dort im Garten zu essen, wo es am gegangen wird, was so. Sei nicht gewesen mit ihm, wo es am Garten rausgegeben, die Provianten. Mhm. Hat mich gefunden, in Herzberg, hat er gesagt, komm ich jetzt mal. Haben sie gemisst, kein mit der Treppe sind splittert gerinnt, und dann sind sie von den Fies, und dann sind sie getrappt. In Lodge, in der Ghetto.
In der Ghetto.
Und die Polizei, die Polizei sind gewesen, gefehlt. Sie sind reingekommen in der
Hand. Are you talking about the Jewish police or the
SS? Yeah, Jewish police. The Jewish, sie gewesen jüdische Militär, jüdische Polizei, alles jüdisch.
And what were they like?
What he do, he is come seine genommen Menschen hat gehabt, dass sie gewählt, der blittige Donnerstück. Hat gehabt in die ganzen Menschen. Und hat dort reingegeben, blittigen in der Halle. Eine Halle dort gewählt zu verkaufen. Hat man reingehabt, Menschen, wer hat gegeben, Gold, den Brillanten, hat man rausgenommen. Wer hat nicht gegeben, habe ich geschickt, die Haare genommen. Auf Kindisch erschienen. Dass sie gewählt, der blittige Donnerstück.
Mm-hmm.
It's everybody know that. Where is if in Lord, you weiß, was die gewähne, der Blittig in der Mischke. Und so sagt er, hier, am Amara, und dann auch, ich weiß, von den Kindern auch, ein Blittig in der Hoch, ein Blittig in der Hoch, was man gemischt, die Kinder alle weg, von einem Monat, von einer Jahre bis 12 Jahre.
Was that after your child had been killed?
Yeah.
After, yeah. Did you know anybody in the ghetto who had a baby while they were in the ghetto?
I got that last nigga stone. The baby's in the door. Oh, that part in the stone. Yeah, for that.
I know you had, but did you have friends who came into the ghetto when they were pregnant?
No.
No.
Okay. No, no, no.
Did anybody you know get married in the ghetto? Were there any weddings?
Yeah, a lot of people, yeah, you asked me a nice question. A lot of people married in the ghetto, and he going to Russia. He just married and taken a boy, and he going back to Russia to the immigration.
Were they able to escape?
They go to Russia.
Who? Yeah,
the people, because Matakivis has had it back. Menschen haben gelaufen. People are scared that Matakivis has a son escaped. We know I've been very bad. We every day, we got wood table, so we put it in. You believe me, you had something, but you never had it. We got table, everything wood, nothing nail. So we put it in the pulse. It enable a little pick up. We say to the table, how long be the crease? We put it in the table, the wood, don't mean that I make a joke. We put it in the, with the pulse. In the table, we ask at the table, to table the wood. And you know, that's it's true. It's saying, he don't say the wood don't talk. No, he picking a little, like.
The table moved?
Just a little, not a pick up a high. The pulse pick up, you know, the pulse. That is the pulse. We put in the pulse.
You put your wrist on the table?
Yeah, it's a little pick up. How long is a little pick up? I forgot, I remember that too. I remember that, you believe me.
So what did you learn from that? What did?
What we learned, not long, two times he pick a little. You know, just to say, just so much. You know, I don't say he's going this high to the himmel. I don't can say that. A little. We, a lot of people doing that, you know. Mm. Yeah, that's about.
So did you think the war was going to last a long time?
Well, I said I lost the time. 1939
is 1945. Right.
That's a lot of we living, you see, and that we can talk to people here. Yeah. Yeah. We mix up a little, it's not so wondering, you know, because we suffer too much.
Right.
I'm happy I can that saying. It's a little mixed up sometime, but in my age, it's not what I say. I think so.
Yes.
I think so. But well, I suffer, you know. And I tell you, I suffer with the hand I come here. I got when I come from Germany here with my husband, got Texas. I get to see my kid. It's come with the mother, but she take care of me. I come from Germany, got Texas.
You know what? But we're getting ahead. Let's not go. We'll talk about when you came to this country in a little while.
Uh-huh.
But in the Ludge Ghetto, you told me when I met with you that there was a song that people sang about Rumkowski.
Yeah.
Can you sing that song for us?
Yeah, we got from the Rumkowski. We sing a lot of things. We sing Rumkowski, Chaye, Mokikitrach, Gaar Betreye, Tugim Banach, Gimacht a Ghetto, Met a Dieto, a Dieto, skinny, a Ghetto, a Dieto, you know, and that's right, that is Gara. Rumkowski Chaim, was in Skigeim, Mannengruppen, verzaten von denen gegessen, man, heintes durch jeder Mann. Rumkowski Chaim, der Beide Chaim, and das ist gefinished. You like it, that's
very good. Yes.
Never?
Yes. And who sang that? When did you sing that?
What? We sing that in the ghettos, going two boys and he's singing that of the hive, you know. Matten gegeben, ungeworfen, mehr in the ghetto. Matten gegeben, mehr besser, jeder hat ungeworfen, mehr besser, you know, was das gab. Kinder, you know, dann nicht ganz essen, ganz gute Sachen gewesen, nothing.
Were there any other songs that came out of the ghetto that you sang? Any other songs that you remember from that time that you sang, or a lullaby that you sang, or anything that stands out in your mind?
Bells, my state, the bells, my name, Levi, Yechab, my Kinder, Shiyun, Zebra. My bells, my stetchko, my bells, Jifchina, Jimoya, Regina, I gave my dom. And be at my house.
Thank you. So let's.
Don't be in my house. I'm up there and build my shelter.
Right.
Is that we lose the home, you know? And we don't have mother home. We lose everything. That's in Yiddish and a little Polish.
And Polish too, yes.
Yeah.
So tell me about the day you were taken from Lodz, you said, at the
end. Like the Furn of Saint Bible, the first week in the White Well, God bet the earth begleiten. Like the Iskan America, gekommen, hat hier geschickt, hat hier geschickt, a Briefer, let's get.
Is that's a song about somebody?
A Yiddish. You know Yiddish. I'm not getting in the home. A Yiddish lady.
About somebody?
I'm not getting in the home. 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 All Yiddish lieder. I'm not getting in the home. Yiddish lieder. I'm not getting in the home.
You can think for a minute if you want.
I don't like it. I forgot that.
Okay, maybe it'll come to you. Was this an appeal in Auschwitz or in the ghetto now? In the ghetto, you sang all these songs?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, tell me about how did you go to Auschwitz? You said that after the Lodz ghetto, you were
Yeah, we making a pill, we closed the home, and we going.
What did they tell you to do?
To Auschwitz.
What
we
did
make
they?
We make a pill, we come to people, and we go off the wagon. We transported the wagon, you know, wagon, but
wagons.
Wagons, yeah.
When you were going to do that, what did they tell you? Did they tell you where you were going or
no,
what was going
to happen? No, he don't tell you nothing.
Mm-hmm.
He don't tell you, now we going, he come and make a bill, we close, we don't can take out nothing. You don't can take nothing from the van.
You couldn't take anything with you?
No. No, nothing.
What about, did you have any jewelry?
Jewelry, wait, when we coming, to Auschwitz.
Okay, how did you get to Auschwitz in those?
Of the wagon, I transported to Auschwitz.
Was it a train?
Yeah, of the wagon, yeah.
Was it an open?
Open wagon. As a market for the keys, the cows, the wagon.
In a cattle car?
Yeah.
An open cattle car?
Yeah,
open.
Okay.
How long was the ride?
Immer dort gefahren, einer geweint, einer hat mich gefühlt, man hat auf dem Kacken gewesen, ich schütte mich Kacke, Pipi, ich gewesen, mitten zu kacken, hat doch ein Biadres.
A bucket?
Ja, nicht auf etwas, sondern Biadres, hat doch ein Basket, hat doch ein Basket, hat doch ein. Und nachdem, immer gesessen, immer gegangen, der SS, dann reingekommen, aufgemacht, nach
rein. How long were you in the train?
We went the train, I think it was an hour, a whole day. A whole day we go, not an hour, and a whole day. And the SS and the Gekima Zirken of the end, because I got a finger of the Epis and the Zirken and the Ungeritten, because I got Epis a Weckl, no jeder einer behalten, you know. A Zach hat uns the Zirken nehmen, the Epis Ungeritten, you know. And
so if you had any jewelry or anything?
I got jewelry, no, ich got zwei Zepp, ich hab mein Schuh gezogen, noch ein got Zepp, you know, aber ich gemacht das auch Käube, wenn du siehst, hab mich geflochten.
You made a braid in your hair?
And I put it in, I got diamond earring, I got a necklace, not everything in the middle, a nice diamond, I got diamond, a wedding ring diamond. I got my husband give me a ring. You know what it was. Everybody got jewelry. And I put it in there. And when I go, when he cut the hair.
Well, first tell me what happened when that you got off the train.
When we go up, we coming up the SS, staying that side and that side, we going on. And he look, it's rechts and links. When all the people in that side, young people in that side. Rechts und links, rechts und links.
But were you with someone?
The SS chain, though, rechts
right.
And links.
Who did you see? Did you see anybody special there? Did you meet?
Was Mabel
we were together. Yeah, I met my father-in-law, met my mother-in-law, I met my husband's brother. We were together in the family, you know. We were not
at Auschwitz.
Yes,
they were
in
there
the ghetto.
Too?
Yeah, we be going.
Wow.
Oh, I don't see anymore. We go not because my father-in-law, my mother-in-law taken before. She's gone off the street of the Smogova gas. She's gone niche of the Smogova. After Volborska got he catching her, he stand up work. My mother-in-law, my father-in-law were alone Peter. You know, and I go with my husband's brother and my two nieces, we go in my husband's my father-in-law, two brothers.
Beckett, so you were all together?
Beckett, so two Beckett and stuff. And we go everybody together, and when we come to Auschwitz, I don't see nobody. We going down, so we have to go into Halle, you know. Outside, staying with the Pishkits, you know. Big Pishkits is saying, a speech, who have gold, diamond, to put it in. And so Pishkits.
Did you put your stuff in
no,
there?
No, I don't push in. I don't do it. I go when it's coming, because when we come, he cut it right away up the head. Like that. He cut up nothing, you know. He and
they shaved your head?
Yeah, he and that's the SS woman why he cut up the hair. So she told me, you got cold? I say yes. She cut it, I say I got I am well scared but because he held that preacher, he killing. Because he held before a preacher we have to give and I don't give it. So I take out and she cut it up and she got it. I don't take it. No, she cut up my whole hair. And I tell her I got it here. Because, you know, and she take it. And when she take it, is again, when everybody's going on, the anyway, of another place.
Was the first thing they did was to cut your hair?
Yes, yes.
Were you dressed? Did
no,
you
no,
undress?
He take out dress. But I'm told he give me Bessie a dress. He make masquerades and us, you know, difference. He taking away everything. And he giving, I'm told, he giving Bessie a dress.
A short dress.
An under one, schmackes, you know. And he take away what we go and even dress to. And we come to Auschwitz, yeah, in Auschwitz, we came by baracken. Baracken, you know.
Right.
Maybe 50 baracks, I don't see one barack. And everybody got his self barack. We got a black tent in Auschwitz. Black tent.
Black tent?
Yeah, black tent. Black tent. And the black sex. Black sex, I'm sorry. Black sex. The Tsigane have black sex. Because I tell you,
the
one Tsigane touched me. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay, but before you get to the block, did you get a number? Were you tattooed at Auschwitz?
Yeah, no, I forgot that just now.
Did you have a tattoo?
6,600. No, I don't remember the number now.
But was it tattooed on your arm, the
yes,
number?
Yes, it was. I saw pieces of things made on face of the Pashak.
It was on your
of
dress.
Of the Pashak, but I got it.
But it was not on your arm?
No.
Okay.
Of the Pashak.
Uh-huh.
Of the Pashak, we got everybody.
Got a number.
Yeah,
okay.
We got a number.
And then you
and
were...
But the appel, he looking of the numbers. You know, you have to tell the number. But the appel, he looking because my big numbers. But yeah. He got me got the numbers and Pacha. Mm-hmm. He got Pacha kids, black, blue, so dark blue, and white. That's the Pacha, but we got it. No button, no pockets.
So in block six, can you describe what it looked like in there?
We like
in block six.
Yeah,
what did it
we
look like, the barrack?
We don't do nothing. No, we got that. We clean up that barrack because it was everybody in our barrack. it was everything not great. You know, we have some trouble. We were maybe a week with we waiting out the air straight, you know. Do you understand? She gave ungelike Kuppers mit verschiedenen Sachen und mir auch geklingt, dass die Messer wegtrugen. And we working very
hard. Outside? Was this outside?
In the barrack, in the outside. In the outside door, man nicht gekannt, da kam nicht heraus.
How did you sleep?
Sie nicht gewählt ausgefinisht, you know, that.
Where did you sleep in the barrack? Where did you sleep?
We sleep off the floor. In Lager, you know, in Lager ist gewesen, also von der ganzen Zeit, hat man das also von aufgestellt, für den Hut, you know. Ich habe vergessen, wie man rief das so, hat man gerade also von uns geschlafen. Haie, bis da gab.
Oh, like a bunk bed?
A Pritches, also von der Pritches, you know, mit Hut, also gemacht.
Did you have your own bed?
No, three people, we were.
Were you with friends? Were you
with friends? Yeah, Ungarisch auch, zwei polnische gewesen.
Do you remember their names?
No. I know the first name, the second name, I don't
know. What were the first names of the people?
But in Lager, man, she took the first name, not the number.
Okay.
Not
but when you were
we don't got
but when you
the
were
name hat man aufgegeben, wenn man sich auch, wenn man sich gewonnen war, you know, das hat man aufgegeben.
Right. But when you were in the barrack, did you know the names of the other people? In the barrack among you?
The first name, yeah.
Yeah. So who slept
the
with you?
The first name. What was Bonatka heißen Rosika, a Mädel, and Bonatka heißen Zelda.
Zelda?
Zelda.
And Rosika.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And did you stay together with Zelda?
Yeah. We stayed together. Now, you know,
what about
mit der Ungarische und mit der Rumänische hat man nicht lieb gehabt. Dann hat man gemacht das Streit. Und man hat nicht gewollt nehmen, das Essen. Und man hat nicht gewollt, was einem gemacht
hat. Why did you go?
Es ist einem gemacht, hat immer so etwas getriegt. Als ein Badestil im Bunker. Ich habe gearbeitet im Bunker. You know, im Bunker war die Getoffel. In der Bunker habe ich gearbeitet.
You worked in the bunker?
Ja, bei der Bunker mit Potatoes, was wir machen straight, wir putten in, you know, was ist shifting the Potatoes, you know. Da habe ich angebringt, ein paar Getoffel. Und als sie hat gesehen, hat sie gemacht, hat ein Office, hat mich geschossen, hat sie. Hat mich gesehen, was kann ich tun, aber sei, lass mich hergehen, in der Insel, jeden, der Rumänische, in der Ungarische, hat mich nicht gewusst, haben zu gehen, also haben wir gemacht. Hat sie, wo sie immer gesagt, hat sie getieren, so gegangen, in Office. Hat mich geschossen.
You, they shot
and
you?
Und ich habe angegangen, wird. Aber ich habe angelegt, you know, die Häuten. Ich habe angelegt. Ich habe angegangen, wird.
So you took a couple of...
Warte, mach mich nicht appell an andere. Die andere Zelda hat mir gehargert. Sie hat auch gearbeitet mit mir in Lage, in Bunker, will ich sagen. Hat mich selbst geschossen. Man hat angegriffen, noch nicht. Und das hat sich nicht geworfen. Man hat gesagt, ich muss überhaupt geschossen. Das ist nicht bloß alle, um das zu getieren. Everybody say was the Rumänisch umgetrieben, der Lage ist überall gewesen. Seine gewählte Menschen in Lage. No good, no good. Und nur die Krieg, als er dort gekommen an mir von der Halle gab, als sie noch nicht mehr Rumänische oder ein Ungarische, immer nicht gewählt zufrieden. Because he do a lot of things, no good, you know. Mm-hmm. Hat mir gemacht, nur aus dem Lage, Blatt mir gewählt together. Hat mir gemacht, Black 6. Das ist wie polnische, unsere polnische Mensch.
So you, the Polish women refused to be with the Hungarian and Romanian women?
Yeah, we were together, you know. Tschechische, oder der Nuch hat mir gemacht, am hat gesagt, am so entschieden. Mit uns dann together. Am hat ausgeschossen, jeden Tag, jeden hat gerade hinge, you know. When you're hungry, you can kill people, you know. And I intimately hing your egg at the cocking stick to the late, the nicht the late. You believe me? When you hungry, when you eat, and I say I'm hungry, you don't believe I'm hungry because you are not rabbit.
You said that the gypsies were in Block 10.
Yeah, Block 10. Yeah, one time I don't got hair, you know. I was young too, you know, not like now I look. And she said, you don't have a...
Did the gypsies have their clothing and their
gypsy
hair?
Yeah, gypsy with their hair, you know. Ugonga, you know,
they were able to keep
it? Got it, yeah.
They did.
No, she tell me, it's a good that the gun like it in Auschwitz. Everybody know. I don't say nothing. So she tell me, give me your hand. I say, no. She took Polish even too.
And what did she tell you when she looked
at your
hand?
She tell me, she said, so, you be lucky. You be rich. And you live long, long time. And you be very happy in your life. And she took off the hand for me. I never had that. And she took me off the hand. And I tell her, well, thank you. Dziękuję bardzo. And that's all.
Did she read the palms of a lot of the other people?
Yeah, she take on the people too.
Did you give
young
were you able,
people, young people?
Did you give her anything?
No, nothing. No, I don't got a what to give. Hair, I don't got that dressing. I don't got anything. I don't give anything. You know, when we go out in the room, so we have to close nothing in your hand. Nothing, nothing, nothing.
Do you know what happened to the gypsies?
I don't know. No, no.
Did you see them again?
No, I see, but I don't remember how long we were there. And later we transported to Birkenau, in Auschwitz to Birkenau. From Birkenau, he transported.
Well,
in Birkenau, I don't remember how long I was either.
You had told me when we met
I
earlier.
I say in Buchenwald that I make a mistake. Birkenau.
Okay.
Yeah,
Before we get too much further, you had told me a story about a Rebbetzin when I met with you earlier.
Yeah.
Was that in Auschwitz?
Yeah, that is by the pearl before we go marshiet. We marshiet to the vagina, you know, Matkemis marshiet to the vagina of Minskifiet.
Was this
an appeal? It was an
in Auschwitz or still in Lodz?
That's in Auschwitz.
In Auschwitz, go ahead.
Yeah, it was an appeal before we go again. So she got from a rabbi. She got a little bit, a siddur.
A little prayer book?
With bindlech, you know, as they get beautiful siddur. You know, a little, so big. And she just ran in the calendar siddur and just give battle to God.
So the rabbi, how old was she?
She was maybe 23 years old, a young, nice girl. Nah. She was married to him. She got with the rabbi too married. He say that she, the SS, that she stay and she settled, you know, but I felt it's coming, he take her out, and he shot her right away. You believe that? That picture I never forget. I suffer in that picture I never forget. And she was up, she go to the Rebbetzin. She work in the barrack by the SS. So she bring me, I got my stomach hurt me, I go anytime, extreme me khaki. And she work and she got that dress. She don't work long a couple days. And she see if I sit and I make any time and go cut. So she bring me underwear, put wearing pants. And she give me in the toilet, not our toilet. Now what we go in Cooper, but Cooper, you know. And she give me take it because I'm sorry for you. I say, is it running for me to cut, you know. And she say, because it was winter time, cold. She was not good, I tell you. I so finna, I remind me that I have to cry finna. So young and so she good, she was. For me, I don't cry no finna, but I see the picture.
We'll stop here and change tape.
Nobody can believe this.
Rosa Feiler, interview tape four.
Yeah.
So,
in Birkenau, this is
how did you get to Birkenau?
That Mitterwagene.
Again, okay.
Again.
Why? Do you know why you were moved from Auschwitz to Birkenau?
Because you see, sie dürfen leider, sie dürfen Menschen zu arbeiten.
Mm-hmm. Had you worked in Auschwitz?
In Auschwitz not. In Birkenau, we don't work much because it was, that was a Dorfgangslage, you know what I say?
Right.
In Germany, a Dorfgangslage.
Right.
Dort in Birkenau, I'm gewesen, maybe a week. Not long. That's how the adults can glide.
Right, so you just were going from one camp to another and you stopped there.
Yeah, there. Uh-huh. And from there, from Birkenau, I was transported. I was gegangen, if she was a night in
a day and a night you went?
Yeah.
And how did you get there?
With a wagon.
Again.
Again,
a closed car or
with
a
wagon.
What time of the year was it? Was it winter or summer?
Winter and summer,
But when you were in the, when you were taken to Mauthausen,
yeah.
Was it cold?
It
was in winter?
In winter. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I came in Dalton and we got about Mauthausen. Mauthausen.
In Mauthausen.
Yeah. Not in Mauthausen, the cotton and the ammunition, or that's what it's geheißen. You know, we must carry it. And the resort, you know, in shop. Dort not my garbage gegangen in the
place. What was the name of the shop that you worked in, the ammunition?
So, Mauthausen, so it's geheißen, the fabric. And dort not my garbage ammunition. And I don't have a cotton, I don't have a nitkis of my garbage. Sie auch, also sie gehen, also wir weiß, you know?
Wires?
Also wir weiß. Ja, hat mir gearbeitet, das ist auch zu ammunition, you know?
Aha.
Weiß, hat mir gearbeitet, der Früh hat mir gemessen marschieren, hat mir gemacht einen Appell in der Monik, und von einem Appell hat man sich weggeführt zu marschieren. Man hat nicht gewohnt, nicht geflogen. Every day.
How far was it?
Das war so 6 Kilometer.
So 6 kilometers each way.
Yeah, 6, one side and one, the other side.
And how many hours did you work?
We worked from the morning, from 8 in the morning, bis 6 o'clock.
And then?
We going home. And we were home gegangen. I had auch gemacht, an Appell, from the Fabrik hat man gezeigt, bevor Menschen mir gegangen, from the factory, and bevor man geht daheim, zum Motto selber Menschen. Immer heimgekommen, kalte gewesen. Excuse me, Leute haben mir gesagt, du weißt, was Leute ist.
Ja, Lice.
Was friert auf dem Kopf, ja, wenn man nicht gerade Gitter nehmen, in der Haut gewahrt, wer denn, you know. Und jeder Mensch hat in sich Wärme, you know. Na, mir haben nicht gerade genug Ernährung gehalten. Hat mir gerade, also mal durchgeredet, excuse me, hat mir gerade Leute, so eine große Leute, in der Ruhe, hat man, war man nicht gerade keine Ruhe. Man hat uns jeder aus mir durchgeredet, die Ruhe.
So they shaved your head again?
Yeah. Die Nuhr, so warte, hat mich schon so durchgeschehen, ich habe ein bisschen zugewachsen, you know. Leider ran, ich habe schon so gewesen. Also man hat immer heimgekommen, hat man, also man sucht, was man gerade auf dem Zettel hat gegeben, hat Perl, ein Stückchen Brot hat mir gegeben, dort ein bisschen Suppe hat mir gegeben für Mist, für Schube, für ein Zuckerheiten, das ist ein Mehl, you know, Suppe. Gruß, sozusagen. Brot hat mir gegeben, Kastanien, so schwarz auf dem Bäumen, da bitter Brot gewesen, da hat man gesehen, dass der kleine Stückchen Brot hat man sich gekriegt, warte. Hat man gesehen, dass der große Stückchen Brot hat man sich gekriegt zu dem Big Piece Brot. Es ist der Hingegewehr, so groß war ihnen, ein Mensch kann sich nicht vorstellen, was die Hinge können machen. Hat man sich weggesetzt. In der Nacht, was hat man gegeben, noch so müssen? Ja, man hat gegeben, die Bigste, hat man gegeben, die Die kleine Wärmle hat sich eine Muschke so geheißen.
Muschke?
Ja, so eine, finde ich eine Kantine, eine Blech. Also eine Muschle.
Out of tin?
Ja, like Kent, also eine Muschle. Wer hat das gekannt essen? Als Sache haben es gegessen, wir haben es gekannt essen. Hier kann ich gekannt essen. In den Uhr, Schabes und Sinti, hat man auch gearbeitet in den Bunkers dort.
And what kind of work did you do?
In Mathe hat man Kartoffel auch gearbeitet. Was man sortiert, die Kartoffel hat man ungeleicht. Und man so leiden, die Kartoffel gleich, you know. Die Säckleich, eins auf den anderen, you know, Säck.
Mm-hmm. So you were working, was it the kitchen that you were working in?
Wie?
You said with the kartoffel.
No, in Bunkers, in the Ehe. Da muss ich sein, wie die Kartoffel mal zugeleicht.
Oh, where you were, in the storage area.
Yeah, that storage, ja, das heißt in der Bunke. In Bunke habe ich gearbeitet.
In Mauthausen.
In Mauthausen, in Bunke auch. In
were you able to get any?
Schabbos, sind die kommen nicht gearbeitet, Schabbos.
What did you do on Sunday?
On Sunday we got entlousing. Was ist entlousing? Man hat also eine Kotzen, also eine Blanket, also eine gele, pinkele Blanket, jeder eine, ein Kotz. Hat mir gemacht Sunday, hat mir gemacht entlousing. Er sagt, an mir gewohnt sind, ich habe keine Arbeit mehr. Es ist auch Valentier, zu gehen arbeiten, zu sein in den Baracken, you know, dort.
If you volunteered to work on Sunday, did you get extra food? Did you get extra food?
Yeah, I get the food. I volunteered because my gemis ziehen the lauses in a back like the lauses for rain it up. I think I gave noch mit dem Batik, das ist gewesen der Kappel. Der Kappel mit einem Assessment, you know, a jüdische Kappel, nicht Kappel.
Right.
Und dann warte, sagen Sie mir so, hier, der Kappel, don't blame it. Sie haben gesagt, das ist ein Kappel, nur noch schießen. Die Kappel sind sehr schlecht auch mit dir in der Lage. Sie haben sehr gemeinsam aufgeführt, you know, very bad. Na, wer, one side.
Did people want revenge on the Kappels?
Yeah. Did yeah, they here. In that, here even, when we come here, when I came from Texas here, if I hear a couple.
You saw someone here as a couple that you remember?
He had to move out from here, and he moved to New York.
Do you remember?
Because he's living here. I don't want to say the name even. No, he moved to New York because he is going here grabbing the people money, and he killed people too, and he lived off an angel. She passed away for 4 weeks, the mother. And the son is so rich, he can give 10 brides, 20 brides diamond with gold. So rich is the son living. And he lived like, he got 2 children, married 2 children.
This that's is the couple?
That thing, that's couple's son.
Mm-hmm.
And the mother passed away for 4 weeks ago. 4 weeks is who passed away.
Just now?
Yeah, an old woman. Mm-hmm. And she passed just away the mother. And she's living like a princess. And the husband passed away for 2 years of cancer.
2 years?
Libel. Everybody know libel. I know.
And he was your capo in Mauthausen?
In Lodge, he was a capo.
Okay, in Mauthausen, what were the living conditions? Were there barracks in Mauthausen that you lived in?
What do you mean?
Did you live in a barrack?
Yeah, in a barrack. Yeah, we got a barrack too.
Did you have your own bed there?
Yeah.
You had your own bed?
Not bed. We got bridges too. Bridges.
Also the bridges bunk beds.
And now she's in the beginning of the floor. And this of ground what Kunisch got. And now she's don't got nothing. Now we lay down on the floor. And the rats is going, so big rats. Rats.
Right.
Yes. Yeah, from the big rat, not a little, not big rat.
And in Mauthausen, how long were you in Mauthausen?
I think a year.
A year.
Yeah, a year.
And what kind of work did you do? 1944
to 1945.
And what kind of work did you do in Mauthausen?
I tell you.
In the bunker? You
in the bunker, and I work in a shop.
What kind of shop? And also ammunition?
Yes.
In the ammunition. Okay. And what was your physical condition by the time of liberation? Were you okay when the war was ending?
I'm not okay.
Did you know that the war was ending?
No, when it ends, it's coming, you know, we work in shop. Mm-hmm. It's coming alarm, a big alarm. Everybody have to go out in Deutsch. Alle Leute haben to go out, around.
Right.
Well, we gehen around. And alle sonst stehen auf ein Platz. We stehen, it's coming Jeeps, American Jeeps, mit big wagene, open wagene mit Wonder Bread. And he started to prove the people is running to taking a bread, or he calling of the microphone, don't everybody get it enough on bread. But I don't can walk, my leg hurt me. I don't report it, nothing. I was scared, he take me off smell. I say, I go to work. And, but my leg was wrong. Sometimes, you know.
After you were shot in the leg, you ever get medical treatment for it?
No, nothing. I was scared to report it. I was scared when I reported he shot me again, you know. You don't know what happened. I don't report it. Sometimes I don't can make me my job. No, I have to do the nerves is working, you know. I did it. I don't say because I'm not living, I won it. I don't say killed. No, but I work. And I make good work. I was good, my nerves working good. Now when we making, when we knew the Krieg, when it was given from Mauthausen.
Okay, so you were in Mauthausen and the Americans came and you said they brought Wonder Bread.
No,
and
not.
Then,
no,
how long?
Not. Yeah. When I, we, yeah, it's coming, we going back in the luggage. Met the American people, met the Americans, and other people in Egypt, so much Egypt, American Egypt. So many, I tell you more than the SS got it. He coming and everybody is stopping, and it's coming back in lager. It's all things speeches. People don't go off no place in Jewish and Polish dolmetschers. Don't run away. It's coming. And he taking, giving a couple days food, bringing us good food, soup, bread, Wonder Bread, potato, a lot of things in chocolate, even cigarettes, everything we got it, you know.
Were you able to eat everything?
No, it's stopping. He don't give meat. No meat, milk, we got it. We got the milk to mix in the milk, dry milk.
Dry?
Okay. Yeah, dry.
Why didn't you get meat?
Because she say, we don't can eat meat. We got a stomach. It's shrinking.
It was your stomach was too small.
Yeah, too small, don't can take. I'm sorry, we got a lot of meat. We American people, we got a lot of meat. No, you don't can eat meat. We don't eat meat. We don't get it as meat. No, we get it baby food.
Really?
Yeah, he said on the day to give baby food. Everything baby food, like the babies.
Right.
The same food I eat too. It's come a doctor's been over to check the people. Everyone have to check. Who got tuberculosis? Go to Switzerland, to Sweden.
To Sweden?
Yes, to Sweden. If they are special for tuberculosis in Sweden. Everybody know they are special. I'm taking it under hospital, in a hospital. I saw, but I got it.
For your foot?
I got the coil from the sheeting, you know. I got inside, you know, and the binocular fold, you know.
Oh, so you had shrapnel from the bullet?
Yeah, I got
in
from
your
the bullet. Yeah, and I saw what happened.
Yes, you showed
so
me.
So he take me in the hospital. In one hospital, the Road Crew take me. In a couple hospitals, but he wanna take me, he say he don't can do. He don't got material to do. He take me again the Red Cross in London, three hospitals in Detroit. He's saying that he take care. It's coming a doctor from Boston. Before I got a Russian doctor, he say he cut me up and leg bit over the knee because the bone, the whole bone no good. We have to cut up the leg. I started, I want to shake me down from the window. I don't want to live. I don't have nobody that I don't. So that doctor say, we don't cut it. We don't cut your leg. I take care. He talk English, I don't match it. Well. And he explained me, and nobody take me make more operations because he started, and I got the wound, and he don't make good, and I bandaged my leg, and I got faint again. So that doctor take his camera, he wash away, he making. He said, I don't can take out. You have to go in another hospital again. The Red Cross. Three times he take me. The Red Cross. And when I go now into the hospital, that doctor, he take care of me. The American man, he say so. We have to wait now a week of this pipe because Germany don't have it there. It's not here. No, that's he have to send me from America. A week you have to wait. I started because he started. I don't got right blood, you know, white with red together.
Right, right.
He say you're not right for him to make just
the surgery.
An no, he feed at me. He give me. He make me. The doctor make me an operation. And that doctor is right for me like a father. He gave me his telephone. He said, maybe you got a chance that you come to America. So you call me up, I explain my vibe, what woman you are. I'm still got that. He said he got a gold watch, not that gold, and he take out and he give me under my pillow. And he said, when you don't have to eat here, so you can solve that watch and you take care of you. And he gonna wake back to America. When I came here to Passau, it was the government that Jewish store. I go in, I say, when I was here, 2-3 weeks, not right away. So I got the telephone him, and I see that man, he got a delicatessen store. And I say, Mr. Abner, maybe you can call me up. That's not here. Now I pay you. He say, we wanna, I say, that's a Boston. In the hospital, that he give me, if in hospital, two numbers in the house. He call up one time, the wife answer, he is not home. I call two times, somebody call for me because I don't can talk. And I talk, and I call up one, and I, the dolmetscher, not a dolmetscher, but he can talk, I tell him, to say, he say he coming not now of Christmas, he is coming to Passau. I was here, not in Passau. He is coming, I live a Fulton place. He is coming with a wife to me from Boston. With a car, he is coming. And he is coming, he gave me, I buy it, this bedroom, but I have it. He buy it me there. I live in a room, I don't got furniture. Because I got in Texas, we come to Texas, and my husband was sick. He got very high blood pressure. I was scared it would not have stroke. So I say, in the hell, I sold everything, and I come here. And when I come here, I call up to the doctor. And the doctor's coming now in a couple of weeks, and he's coming. He buy for the baby electric train. He give me $500, the wife give me.
Very special.
And she bring me coin even from there. She come the second time. And she bring clothes for my kids too, for their grandchildren. From Texas, she's coming with the car. And second time me see, you believe me? And she buy me, I got a big fridge there, and he buy it for me. And she say, what you need it? And I take out to my Willy, he got so blouse, so short, a short shirt, he put it in $20 in the pocket. Okay. And she don't tell. And I call, and he call me when I talk English, I talk, and he talking a little bit to Germany. He talking, not much of the he understand. Okay. Now he was such a good doctor, kiss me. I never see so person. Honest to God, he talk to me so bad. He kissed me. He take out the watch. I don't tell him take out the watch and give me.
And he's the doctor who took care of your leg.
And he take care of that leg. And he don't cut. And the Russian teller, he started. And I got a wound more. It's hurting me. He make a bandage. You know, he put in something, medication. You know, and he take care. He said, I don't cut your leg.
How long were you in the hospital?
I've a long time.
And then where did you go?
And you believe me, the Red Cross, nobody got money. And the Red Cross find out too. One time I got a postcard. I live a Fulton place. And second time he sent me a big check. A big check. I go from Germany. But he taking to give up in Germany everything. I go to him, I show it. He said, that's a lot of money, a Germany Jew, but you pay him to make the every paper from Germany to get money. I don't make it. Not the Red Cross making me everything. Mm-hmm. Because he got everything, my name and everything, you know.
So that doctor sponsored you to come here?
Who?
Did that doctor sponsor you? Is that what you're saying? Did he make it possible for you to come here?
No.
No, the Red Cross.
That's not at all. Okay. No, that is making, you know, that is making the Hadassah. Not the Hadassah,
Hayas.
No, the Hayas.
Uh-huh.
The Hayas.
Okay, let me just backtrack a little bit. You were in the hospital a long time.
Yeah.
Where did you go after the hospital? After the hospital.
I don't go no place because you're taking me away from Mauthausen.
Right. After Mauthausen, you said you were in the hospital a long time.
Yeah.
Then you also
when
mentioned
I
Passau.
Go home.
When did you go to Passau?
To Passau, it's transported me. What is taking to Passau. From Lager, they are not far to transport it.
Right.
And they have a Gemeinde, but he take, like Rumkowski, he take care of the Jew but coming back from the Holocaust,
right.
You know?
Right.
He take care. And he give me a room.
In
he go to SS, what he was SS, and he say, go to house from house.
And I got
everything I got.
When did you find out or about your family?
We were Eastern, a cider, you know, Eastern Paisoe, we make a cider, you know. And the Gemeinde making a cider, you know.
In Passau?
The whole was it's in Passau, the Jew, that was Jewish Gemeinde. I come here making a cider from everything, from knedel, from matzah, from soup, from chicken, from everything, you know. We got a shoyaket. We got everything, a kultus gemeinde, you know. And I come there too. It's coming there. The president is coming, but he take me because I live far.
He
have to take me. He got a car too.
Right.
And he take me in the car in the gemeinde. I be there, my husband sitting, I sit here, and my husband sitting there. And we start talking. He asked me, well, I am like you talking to me. I talk to him the same thing. I live after Sederstrasse, 1680, and I have I talk to them where I live and everything, and we sit and we eat together, everybody, not just me and my husband, but maybe more than 40 people. At about the second day, we come again, it's holiday, you know, and we sit again together. And a week we have faces, you know, and I talk to him, he talk to me, Polish, Yiddish, you know, and we talking from our life, you know, like you started to go. Well, I invite him to come in my house, you know. That's husband. He is coming in my house, he bring me a gold watch. He bring me earring, my diamond, a little diamond. For your dinner, I bring you that. No, but I live there in Germany, living one from Russia. A man, a nice man. No, he got very rough character. And he won't marry him. He see me, he won't right away marry. No. I don't marry nobody. I'm sick, even too. I don't marry. No, but my husband, you know, he don't know what to do for me. He say, everybody say, are you a queen? I was nice, even nice woman. You see after picture where I look not what I tell you. No, but he was going to go to me when he is old, 100 years I married him. He was good. He talked to me and hear him. Everybody here. It's 3 years, 1995, my husband passed away. I live here 20 years. Everybody give me so expect. I'm not drunk, I'm not with men, I'm not collected, but a lot of company too, you know, because in everybody, the teenagers give me so much expect, more than my children. Wintertime, he don't let me out. He go shopping what I needed. Gentile, not even Jewish. And he bring me in the house. And the garbage he put in from the window, we go in
right.
The garbage.
Well, those are teenagers
now. And that's about me so much, you know.
Mm. All right, but tell me, when did you get married? Let's go back to Paso.
Yeah, not so right away I married, you know. My husband wants to marry. Now I thinking. And that man, but I tell you, he was a Russian man. He liked to drink, you know, and I don't like it. I tell him. And I don't go, he give me a ring, a nice ring he give me, and he give me a nice change. Now my husband, is he talk to him any time that he might die, you know. He giving a loan, not I giving. He say, Rose, give him this back. And that's all. And she tell me same time, see you excited? That's the abundance, I can do that. I say, I do. I don't want. I don't like it because you're drinking, and I don't like it. And I go with my husband maybe 2 months, and I married him, and he make a wedding. How many from helicopter were there living in New York, ladder? I got a name of weddings and the children, and we were everybody all together, you know, mm-hmm. And everybody liked me.
So when did you get married? What year was it?
1948.
1948.
My dead husband, yeah.
Right. And his name?
Huh?
What was his name?
Bernard.
Bernard Feiler.
Yeah, Bernard Feiler.
Right. Yeah. And when was your son born?
My son is born in October 26th. October 26th.
What year?
October. What?
What year? Was your son born?
My son born 19.
Was it 49 or 50? Your son.
40. When he married.
No, when your son was born. Willie.
My son was born. I tell you, he born in October 26th.
And the year?
The year.
Okay, we'll get to it later. Okay, we'll stop here and change tape.
Rosa Feiler, tape 5. Mrs. Feiler, would you just tell me again, what year was your son born?
1949. Okay. He was born in Passau.
And that was in Germany?
In Passau, in Germany.
Right.
Yeah, you see the paper in Passau, he got it.
And when did you come to the United States?
When I came, I think 1950.
In 1950. So your son was about a year old when you
came? Yeah, a year old that died of the shift. Okay. I stealing him. He was such a nice baby. I tell you, such a beautiful baby. Everybody from the captain giving me an orange chocolate because he liking how he walking, how he move. He steal him for a couple hours. He's such a nice baby. But I got, when I go off the ship, I got from everything he giving me, you know. And my husband is working off the ship too, because we go on, I think, 4 weeks off the ship.
4 week trip?
Yeah.
Do you remember the name of the ship?
I forgot it.
Okay. And you said that you came to Texas.
To Texas. In Texas, I came. We come with a train. We go.
Where did the boat land?
With a train we go.
But where did the boat dock? Where did the boat arrive?
In Passau.
And to where? Did it come to Texas?
Where not did the to boat Texas.
Right. Where did the boat come to?
From Germany.
Right, okay. And how did you settle in Texas?
Yeah, from Germany you bring me to Passau. I take from the hospital. He bring me to Passau. Yeah. Okay. I say good.
Okay.
To Passau.
Okay. And when you got to Texas, where did you live?
I live off the Truxilla 52, Train 50. I live there.
What city? Do you know what remember?
Houston, Texas.
In Houston?
Yeah.
I see. Did the Jewish community?
And we come in with a bomb. You know what's
a bomb?
Yeah. A train with a bomb we come. It's waiting ladder because it's coming ladder from the helicopter, you know. Uh-huh. Not myself. It's coming ladder.
A lot of people came.
Yeah, from the helicopter.
Did you know anybody in Houston? Did you know anybody there?
Ladder's living there. I go out because my husband was sick. He got very much high pressure, you know.
Uh-huh.
I was scared. The doctor say he can get a stroke from the pressure, you know.
Right.
So I say in the hell.
So where did you live in Houston?
When you come back from Houston here to
No. How you lived in Houston?
I lived there a year. Work,
a year.
My husband don't can get it.
Right.
I get it 23 years, $23 a week for a cup for a person. For me, with my husband, and for the baby, for my baby.
Mm-hmm.
And but I the day. I be there, I got in everything, no meat, I don't got it in the fridge there, from milk, from orange juice, from fruit, from everything. No meat, not. She saying on the day I take you shopping meat.
Who is she?
That's about the mother, what she take care of. Everybody got a mother, every couple got a mother, what she take care of, one out of two couples.
Do you remember the name of the woman? That was your mother?
Yeah, from my mother. Oh. I know she is named by Helen Elterman. And she take care of me.
Did you live in her house or did you have
your
own?
No, she rent 5 room, I got it.
5 rooms?
Yeah, and everything of the bed, everything, the linen, and linen ladder and for the baby a crib. Everything is nothing what I have to buy. And everything new one, not old things. In fact, I got the nun the day she's coming, and she takes me shopping, meat. And I go in a big store, I see such a big hall, with geese, and with catchkis, guagua, and chicken, and everything. And she asked me, you get the chicken. I say, is that kosher? She say, no, kosher is very expensive. You can get one chicken. I say, one chicken kosher. And I bring him one chicken. But I got a neighbor there, a German Jew, but he sold chicken. He got a sugar in the house, and he killed the chicken, and he takes me to help to take out everything, you
feathers
know, from the chicken.
And
I go right away work. My husband don't go to work. And I work by my neighbor that's 3 hours from me in Texas. And I work by him, and I got everything I got from the neck. I got from the vein. I got from the girdle. I got the leg. And he give me a chicken, too. So I got enough chicken and chicken. And one time I go to a butcher. I tell him, give me fat meat. He give me kishker. He say, when I don't count you kishker. No, I wanna, when you make the kishker, you bring me a piece of kishker? Oh, yes, I say. I make it. He say, I give you meat of chul. You make, I make. I bring in chul, he give me meat. He give me everything. He say, he never eat that. I make chul, I bring in my half kishker because it don't cost me. I lucky because people like me, and I say, because I bring you, love it. No, he say, nobody can make my mother don't make so much kishker.
So when did you come to New Jersey?
To New Jersey, I got a friend here, but he was the godmother for my son.
The Sunday?
Yeah, the Sunday. I write a book, I don't can be there because I don't want to lose my husband. What I can do, he say, we want here, write me a letter. For you, I got place, we together. We were together, we again together. I come there, I was there, she's going to work. I don't can go, I take care of her child, of my child. You know, she got one child, and together, raised, you know, like brothers and sisters. She go to work and I take care of both children. I don't go work, my husband go. No, he don't make much money. I say here, Dr. Jordan. But I lived there maybe 8 months and I look for an apartment. I don't can get it cause a lot of money. I take by Jewish landlord. He say, never, nobody live in that apartment for you taking because of a headache, you know. And the headache was off the head, and not much money. I say, I take it. It's coming, my son got the money, the baby. The doctor coming up, he not tall, Dr. Jordan. He was, Robert Jordan, the doctor, see, the son. He is here, in Fairlawn. He's coming.
So where were you living? Were you in Patterson
In Patterson, yeah. I came from Texas to Patterson. I sold and I got money, I tell you, for the furniture, for everything, and I come here. I was there a couple months. I go and I take that apartment. It's coming Dr. Jordan. Because he was so sick, he got temperature. He's coming. He said he have the money. He is sick. So he said, please, why you have clothes off the change the door? Yes, I say because I have to be, because the very that is off the head. Somebody's coming, hurt the head, or I close off the chin. The doctor say, will you come? He start me to ask, and he bothered the church. He say, he have the money. He say, look at, you're such a nice lady, you don't go nice there. That's a dumb way at that country. I say, that's a from Europe. He say, see, you don't got it? I say, I got it. I got clothes. He said, in America, one thing is not to be ashamed. When you be ashamed, so you can stand. Nobody take care. I say, well, he's coming one time, two times. So he come every second day, he's coming up. I lived in the top, you know, of medic. So one time, I said, doctor, please, you know, I'm from the helicopter, not what I please you, you give me something. No, I want to know how much is the visit I can pay. He said, listen, you got so much money what you can pay? Yes. He said, no, I don't take money. You don't pay nothing, he said. He go on the drugs, and he buy me everything when you burn, when you cut your finger, when you got a headache, everything, a whole box, medication from drugs, bandages, different, everything from drugs he bring. And he taking out $25, and he giving baby. And he say, don't let him over 2 weeks, don't go out with the kid. And he say, when you need something, you tell me. We able, we people, American people, what we have to help. He say, my son is Dr. Roberts, he say. He gone before clean his shoes with a box, and he put it in paper. And now he's a doctor. It's not a shame here in that country. I say, doctor, maybe you give me, I have experience to work in a hospital because I'm handy to that. He said, no, here you have to go college of that to be noise or something. No, well, I say, I tell my husband make 75 cents an hour. And we two people. He say, I know not enough. No, when you want what I tell you, I got a lot of passages, but she come home from the hospital, and you can build up, not to clean it, food to give, to make what something to eat. In that you got more pay, you go in a shop, I think so, and you make good money. And I think, and he said, you don't have to give away the baby, the husband is in the house in the night. And you go to work on the night, you don't have much to do, you know. And I did it. It's true. And I work and I make. And later on, I work in the day too. When the kids started to go in the yavne, in the yeshiva, he go off a day, so I work in the day. And I work late hours too to make money.
Tell me, what did it mean to you when your son had a bar mitzvah, his bar mitzvah?
Huh?
Tell me about the day your son had his bar mitzvah. What did that mean to you?
Well, when my son, well, I tell you, when my son got the bar mitzvah, I don't want to make no break. Now, my husband starts to cry. He say, we lose, he got children, he got 2 children, he losing the war. He got a wife, I had the second wife. And he say, we got the knockers, we got a child. So we have to make a big bar mitzvah. Our friend be happy because he got a lot of friends. I got 6 rooms and I don't got enough chairs. So any friendly to everybody, when you believe me, anytime company. I make a big bar mitzvah in, I tell you, in Clinton Manor. Clinton Manor, that's a big hall. And that I make the bar mitzvah, Clinton Manor. Big hall, and I bow mitzvah of a wedding. A wedding is not so. It's making wedding. The wedding was in Clinton Manor too. But my son was Clinton Manor, the wedding.
The wedding too. Also.
The bow mitzvah, the wedding of the same place, you believe.
Yeah. Did you talk to your son about your experiences in the Holocaust? Does your son know what you went through?
In what?
The Holocaust.
He was in Washington, D.C.,
right.
But the Holocaust,
so
he say asked both name, my name and daddy's name.
Uh-huh. But when he was a youngster, when he was in school, did you talk to him about it? Did you talk about the Holocaust?
Because if we talk, I got a lot of friends. But it's coming, but now it's dead, because you know.
But in those days.
And now we talk any time. I make candle, you a chat, you know, everything. Mm-hmm. He know. Mm-hmm.
You said that when you were growing up in Poland, you were very Orthodox.
Yes, very Orthodox.
What about here? What about now?
Now, I tell you, listen, I got a milk fleishy.
You know, so you're kosher. It,
yeah,
you're kosher.
And kosher meat, I order bahawot, order Ben David, Ben
right.
David and fella.
Okay.
That I buy meat. Kosher. Now, I make one sin, no good, no God for apologize me. I go to the Davina Rashi Shuni Yom Kippur, you know, and I don't go with a car because I sleep by my friend. I sleep there because Rashi Shuni Yom Kippur, I make my food and everything, and I there is coming with a car. The son, he take me, and I stay Rashi Shuni Yom Kippur. You know, I don't go with a car.
You also
no, but I make a sin, but I go sorry to play bingo. That's what I do. I don't have the rabbi, so I'm not the rabbitson. You know, when the rabbi is not there, so I'm no more rabbitson. So I do, I say that to everybody. I sorry that I go play bingo. Mm-hmm. I don't want to stay in the house, you know. So every day I go out. I go out every day, not just not Saturday. I enjoy it because I go out at 10 o'clock. My neighbor takes me. Mm-hmm. It's 3 o'clock. Mm-hmm. Saturday, I don't cook. Friday, I make a Saturday and a Sunday. And that's all. Mm-hmm. And I don't cook. I got everything, not just that what I do. Saturday, I go play bingo.
Okay.
Yeah, that I do. This. I candle every Friday. I do. Everything the same thing.
I know that you have a grandson.
Yeah. Honest to God, like we have got, but yesterday he called me up. I send a check and a card.
It was his birthday.
Yes, it's the birthday. He got Monday the birthday, the 9th. November 9th he born. In November 9th. So he called me yesterday. Grandma, I love you. Thank you, Grandma. How you feel, Grandma, tell me. I say, I'm okay, Edward. How are you? You good student? You learn? You still going to yeshiva? He say, yes. You like it? Yes, he say. I say, Edward, when you learn good, is everything for you I make it. Everything I give you. I say, you when you came, he said, when daddy takes me, I came. I don't get the right.
What would you want your grandson to learn from your Holocaust experience? What would you want him to learn from all of this?
No, he not. My daughter-in-law is not to say she don't want to listen. And that's and my son. He know we people what we suffer from the Holocaust. He know because he was in the house. He never don't go out. But he married. He don't sleep off nobody's place. No. And he don't eat for nobody. Sometimes I give him, invite him to eat, or the what he don't say, I'm to you kosher to not. So he say, Mom, you know what, you don't believe what I do the first time he tell me. I feel like I don't can swallow. He stay me in the middle, he say, what I do? I take in the bedroom, I put in my finger, excuse me on the time. And I give out because I don't know, and I don't can say to coaches or not. He say, you sushi boy, are you ask that? So he say, I eat. Not much, or that I eat. I say, I'm not hungry. But later when he started with her, she don't believe it. So no, never not synagogue. And she say, when I stir, he can put me on in the ocean. Or that he can bring. She don't believe in that. Now, how long? That's it. I got knackers too. Now she candle. I give her a big, oh, look at that. Look at what I got it. A candle lighting, silver one, a big one.
So your daughter all lights the candles
that I give now because she go. Now she changed the dishes because she asked questions. She buys now kosher meat too. I'm happy. And when he's coming before up, I got him to draw yarmulke. So he started to take out the yarmulke and he put it, and he making when he drink water a goofen, a wine a goofen, he say, water a shackle, he make it the whole bray, you know. And he know everything, and that's why me move, I got the money in the bank.
Right.
You know, I see, he raised, but not a rabbi, he's a Jew. My son can definitely go, he gone to Yavne, you know. He talk with every, he gone to Yeshiva, I don't have to say, but he know. He was the best child. He never won a lot of money to spend of dressing, of a suit. Because he say, I lay down off the floor, I don't need, he don't let me spend money. And honest, he don't want money. I got here a lot of antique, a lot of nice things in the, I say, really take it. She like it, I got there a bache, you know what you drink wine, a big one, six small one, this is very modern now. So she say, I like it. Oh no, Johan, you don't can take it. How long, Mama, last day, nobody's taking, it's yours, but not now. You don't can touch. I got a lot of antiques, see, done too. A lot of things, but I don't buy it now. We travel a lot. We run a lot of state, you know. Mm-hmm.
Tell me how you feel about Israel.
I like Israel. I buy it 2 times, 20 minutes. In Netanya, and in Herzliya, I buy it of nice sex and everything, new one, not bad finish, of the blueprint, you know. I buy it, not bad. When I came home, I said to my son, he married well. No child, he don't got it. I say, well, I buy, say, mazel tov, mommy, mazel tov, good luck. He say, what happened? You got a baby there? He make laughing. I say, no, I buy my home there. I like Israel. And we have to be in Israel because this is a Jewish land. And we belong to the Jew from the Holocaust. We have that. It's been founded 100 years ago by Jewish, and now we build up again Jewish. Huh? So he said, Ma, you're talking like a baby. You don't have more children with one son. And when you got to be the daddy is sick, so what you do, I can come to us. The airplane wait for me. You can, when I do that, what you say, I have a son, but he is no good for nothing. And Ma, you can do that, so you buy it, and you stay in Israel, I hear. And he fight with me. Well, I go again, it's a couple months, it's built up a little, I don't lose money, I win. Because at any time cost more money, and I feel so. Another time I got a fight, I say, never. That's my home, and that's Israel. I buy in Herzliya.
Okay, we'll stop here and change tape. Okay, we can continue. Is there something you'd like to add about all of this?
What?
Is there something you'd like to add yet? About?
Add?
To add. Anything else you would like to say? Anything you'd like to say to your grandson on the tape?
In the tape?
Yeah, anything you'd like to say yet?
Yeah, my grandson. I tell him a year ago, my son got a big, what is given God, what he got it, a computer. My son have he buy, he don't got children, so he spent the bed. He got a television over the whole world, because he say, I don't have children, so I have a...
So, but what would you want to say to your grandson?
Yeah, I say, because really, my really complained, he break the computer, and that cost a lot of money to fix. So he was here, I say, Edward, listen, you come with daddy with me and I buy you a computer, what you like it. He said, no, grandma. Because when you buy a car, every year it's something different, a button to something else. It's not more from that year. In which I grow up, I break my computer, it's nothing. So he said, no, I don't want it now. When I grow up, Grandma, you buy me. I like daddy's computer. So, but I buy him a car when he was 6 years old. I buy him a car for $150 with pedals. Like a auto, you know, to drive with everything. We go to special toys where he making the factory. It cost more. Now Willie take me and he pick up what he like it. So I buy him. Money I don't give him. I give him pennies. Anytime I give him a bunch pennies, a packet 50 cents new pennies. Before he say, I'm so rich, I got a lot of penny. Every week when I come to Grandma, I got money. And then now in money, nothing in pennies, he say. Now I give him the check, he say, thank you, Grandma. He kiss me off the telephone. I give you 100 kisses, Grandma. Thank you, I love you.
Thank you very much for sharing your story with us.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It's nice. Bernard and Rosa Feiler. That is Bernard and Rosa. That was November 48 in Passau, in Germany. That is Rosa and Baru Feiler and the baby, really. That was 1949.
Where?
In Passau. That's Willy Feiler, he born in Germany, Passau. That's Willy Feiler, that's in Patterson, this is the Bau Mitzvah picture. That's Willy in my daughter-in-law, Johann, and he Bau Mitzvah
his wedding.
In Clinton Manor, even by the wedding. And what
more? What year?
I think 1972. That is my son, Edward, Willy Feiler.
No, I think, are we talking about your grandson?
My grandson, yeah, that's Edward Feiler. Yeah, Edward Feiler. I don't see you.
Right.
Edward Feiler, yes.
And where was this?
My grandson.
Right.
Yeah, that's my grandson,
okay.
Edward. That's